Yo gang, and welcome to your 6.5th REST API tutorial. And in this video I'm going to introduce you to Postman, which is some nifty software to help us test our API routes. Okay then, so in the last tutorial we created these different route handlers using the Express Router. So we've got a handler set up for the get request, the /ninjas, a post request, a put request and a delete request to these different endpoints right here. I remember /API goes in front of each one of these because in our index file we said app.use and we're using those routes for anything which starts with /API. Okay, so then how the hell do we test out these different routes here, these different handlers, make sure they're all working correctly? Because we don't have a front end to this application making requests, and we certainly don't have a third party app or a mobile app or something like that making requests to these different handlers right here. So what are we going to do? Well, yeah, we could test out this get request handler by typing in the endpoint into a browser, because remember a browser uses get requests by default, so we're going to get this response in a browser. However, these ones here, the post, put and delete, we're going to have a much harder time with, because we can't do that via a browser. Okay, we have to do that via code typically from another application or a front end. So the situation is this: we have our API on the left over here, we have Express app running in Node.js with our different route handlers set up, listening, waiting for requests to them. We also have MongoDB running in the background, but we've not really touched this yet, so don't worry about it for now. So the idea is one of these things over here on the right are going to be making requests to this API, right? Either a front end, a mobile app or another website. So another website, for example, could make a get request to this endpoint. And this API, this app, is going to look at it and say, okay, I've set up a handler for this get request and I'm going to run this code and handle it. Or this could be a put request or a post request or something like that, okay? So this is going to handle whichever request comes along. However, since we don't have any of these things on the right at the minute, we need to kind of simulate these requests to make sure they're behaving as we would expect. Enter onto the scene Postman, which you can get at getpostman.com, which is some really cool free software which is going to help us test out our different route handlers by simulating these different requests: put, post, delete and get. So you can download this by clicking one of these buttons here. Depending on your operating system, you may have to sign up, but once you do, you can open this bad boy right here, which looks a little complex at first, but don't be put off because it's really simple. So we have our different request type on the left here. Get, post, put and delete are what we're going to be looking at. Then right here we can put in our endpoint, our URL. We can also add parameters, query parameters that is, with a key and value pair. And remember, query parameters are those things at the end of an endpoint or URL where it has a question mark, then a variable name such as name equals the value of that. So for example, question mark name equals Yoshi. Alright, so they're query parameters. We can add those onto, which we'll take a look at later on. And we can also add in custom headers and body. Not for a get request, but if we go to post, we can add the body right here so we can send data to the API as well. So we're definitely going to be taking a look at that later on. For now, I just want to make simple requests to each of our four handlers. So one get, one post, one update, and one delete, right? I say update, I mean put, this one right here. So let's take a look at our different handlers. So remember, we're going to /ninjas, but with /API in front of it. And this is a get request. And for this one, it's the same, /ninjas. And in each example, we're just getting a simple object back with a property of type inside, which is telling us the type of request we have made. So get, post, put, and delete. We'll take a look at these two in a minute, but let's do these two first of all. So if we open up Postman, and we want to start with the get request. So first of all, we're going to localhost. I remember this is at port 4000 that we're listening for, /API, /ninjas. So we're making a get request to this endpoint and we should get that object back. So let's press send and sure enough, we get that object back. Cool, this is working. Let's try the post request. This stays the same because it's the same URL we're going to, look, /ninjas. So let's send again. This time we get post back as the type. Cool. So those two are definitely working. Okay, so we want to try out now the put and delete requests right here. So notice this third part at the end, which we added on to the route. And this is a variable or parameter, if you like, and it can be anything. It comes after /ninjas, and it could be Yoshi, it could be whatever, it could be some random string, right? But whatever it is, that's fine. What's going to happen is when it reaches this route handler, Node.js and Express is going to take whatever the user types into this request, okay? And it's going to pop it onto the request object right there so we can access it. So say, for example, this is some unique ID of a ninja. Then it's going to pop it onto this request object. We can access it down here, grab that ID, query the database, and find that ninja. We're not going to be doing that now. We're going to be doing that later on. But for now, I just want to test out this route. So all we need to do is put something after ninjas. We need to say / something else, okay? Because this is the route for the put, and this is the route for the delete request. So let's do that. So /API, /ninjas, / something. I'll say Yoshi for now. So if I send this, we want to change this to put, first of all. Send it. Now we get put back. And if I do the same for delete, we should get delete back. Okay, cool. Now check this out. If I don't add this on, if I take that off and still try to make a delete request to this route, then this is not going to work. It says cannot delete /API /ninjas. We don't have a delete request, or handler rather, set up for this request to this endpoint. There has to be something after it, as specified in our route handlers right here. This has to exist, okay? So that all works. We've tested out our four different route handlers using Postman, and that's really how simple it is. We are going to be using this more as we go deeper into this course to add different parameters and body data right here. So that is Postman in a nutshell. It's really cool. I really hope you enjoy this video, and you can put this to good use when you're creating your own APIs. Oh, one more thing. If this is not working, then you might want to check out your console right here to make sure you've said NodeMon index, to make sure your application is actually up and running. Otherwise, you won't get any response down here. So either say NodeMon index or Node index, and then you should be fine.